Hello, and welcome to Web Technology Core Concepts at Learning Journal. In the earlier video, I talked about a website address or a web page's address. In this video, we will elaborate a little more on the same. If you want to open a website or a web page, you must know its address. However, there are multiple terms that people use to refer a website address. A layman will always call it a website address, and there is no confusion in that simple terminology. But if you talk a little more technically, people often use and get confused with these three different terms. URI, which stands for Uniform Resource Identifier. URL, which stands for Uniform Resource Locator. And URN, which stands for Uniform Resource Name. Most of the people use them as a synonym. However, they are different things. Do you understand the difference? Will you be able to explain the difference clearly? That's the topic for this video. So let's get started. If you look carefully at the full form of these three things, they differ in their last word. The identifier, the locator, the name. The key to the difference lies in these three words. Let's start with an example. Do you like James Bond movies? What is his name and code? James Bond 007, right? Do you think it uniquely identifies the character over time and space? If no one in the past, present and future uses that combination in our world, we can think of it as a unique identifier for James Bond. That's what a URI means. It's a Uniform Resource Identifier. So, the James Bond 007 could be a URI for James Bond. Let me ask you another question. Using the above URI, can you locate James Bond? No, right? You cannot locate the resource because the URI does not contain an address. Let us add an address to the URI. James Bond 007, number 30, Wellington Square, London. Great, now it becomes a URL. When we add address details to the URI, it becomes URL. The L stands for locator. However, there is an important point to note here. The URL still uniquely identifies the James Bond, so it is still a valid URI. In other words, URL is a subset of URI. The diagram explains it more clearly. Great, now let's come to the URN. The URN is like a URI that uses a special naming scheme to identify a resource uniquely. However, since the web pages don't follow the naming scheme, the URN doesn't have enough significance regarding web technologies. So most of us tend to ignore that term. However, URN is also a unique identifier that uses a special name to identify a resource. But you should remember that if a URN doesn't contain location information, then it won't be a valid URL. Let us try to improve our earlier diagram. The diagram explains a lot. However, let's summarize few points. A URL is always a URI. A URN is also a URI. Some URL is also a valid URN and vice versa. A URI may or may not be a URL or URN. However, to avoid this confusion, W3C, which is the main international standards organization for the World Wide Web, issued a URI clarification document. The document clarifies that URI and URL are the same things. So, after all that discussion, in terms of web technologies, the URI and the URL can be used as a synonym. In a layman's language, we call it a web address. Great! Let us look at an example web address. This example uniquely identifies a web page and it is a URI. It also contains enough information for the browser to locate the page. Hence, it is a valid URL as well. Hope that makes sense. Great, that's it for this session. See you again with a new concept. Thank you for watching Learning Journal. Keep learning and keep growing.